two more. What'll happen to Miss McDevitt's folk if we send power to the Vale?
No, 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 just leave me alone! No, 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 just leave me alone! You're not real! You're not real!
Mind the steam. You're liable to get scalded.
Unexpected processing. Since beginning,
Incoming. Security
patrol. Dissident. Target.
One to go. If we send the power to Miss McDevitt, what happens to the Vale? gone quiet. I'm not sure what the riot is. All I know is the decision's final. Once we do this, there's no going back. Hey, mister? Look, I know you want your power regulator and all, but I just gotta ask you. Do you understand what you're about to do? I don't think you should cut off Edgewater's power. I think it would be cruel. I'm sorry. That just sort of came out all at once. Edgewater's hurting. We've been losing workers year after year, and corporate hardly ever sends replacements. There's barely enough Saltuna to fill our bellies anymore. But the town's got some good people in it. Decent, hard-working folk just living their lives the only way they know how. They don't deserve to be punished. Well, that sure sounds like Mr. Thompson. If he was standing here, I imagine he'd remind us of how we're all one big, happy Spacer's Choice family. In Mr. Thompson's eyes, those deserters are still part of the Spacer's Choice family. The family must work together in order to survive. I hate to say it, but I think Mr. Thompson's got a point. Unless those deserters come back, Edgewater's as good as dead. Cutting off their power might be the only way. Miss McDevitt's built something beautiful. Somehow, she's talked the ground into giving life again. It's plain to see she's made the Vale a better place. Fed the hungry, tended the sick. Gave a home to those that had none. But Miss McDevitt delights in Edgewater's suffering. She wants to hurt the town. Do you really want to be party to that kind of hatred? Sorry, I didn't mean to babble on like that. I felt like I had to say something. Really? I mean, wow. Thanks. No one's ever told me those words in that order.
Adelaide was right to leave.
Desertion is a criminal offense, punishable by hard labor.
Oh, it's you. Reed told me I should be expecting you. He's inside. Hell of a time to start looking for work. Lucky for you, I am authorized to hire freelancers even during times of crisis. Know how to carry yourself in a fight? I've got bounties out for these three marauders. Cross them off and bring me their fingers. Just one per marauder, please. I'll dust off the old fingerprint roller. As long as your quest. His likeness decorates many a wanted poster. Do you. I am obliged to warn you against forming acquaintanceships, friendships, partnerships. I am also obliged to inform you of our referral program. For every criminal you. Wells has been wanted for as long as the board decides he has been wanted. This decision will be made in accordance with Wells' behavior upon arrest. Unfortunately, the arrest of Mr. Wells falls outside my authority. I enforce the company policy as Wells is wanted by the board. If you have information related to the location of I represent Spacer's Choice. Spacer's Choice is a wholly owned subsidiary of Universal Defense Logistics, which is itself a member of the Halcyon Holdings Corporation Board. Also, I specialize in processing fingerprints, so unless you're carrying Wells' finger on you, there's not a lot I can do for you. Any information regarding outstanding bounties and wanted criminals? Halcyon's original colony ship, now repurposed into a space station. Mr. Udom Bedford represents the board's interest on the Groundbreaker. Something else I can do for you?
Big to find time to visit, stranger. Foreman Granger, mind those words don't come out of your mouth unless preceded by yes or right away or thank you.
What can I do for you?
Just keep your fingers to your own self, okay?
You want to know what gets my bile churning? Edgewater has suffered a cavalcade of disasters. Plague, marauders, desertion. Then you wandered in town. And I was so damn sure our luck was starting to turn. I never knew how right I was. Just answer one question for me. Why'd you do it? Is that right? I'm dying to hear this. Please, educate me. liberating? Edgewater is my home. The only home I've ever had. I put down roots here, gave decades of my life to this place. I never asked to be liberated. Whatever you were hoping to find down here, I advise you to turn around and leave. I have got guards posted with orders to fire on you. All right, easy now. Let's not do anything we'll regret. I'll order my guards to stand down. Take what you came for and then leave us be. Stand down, all of you. We're done here.
Is this your ship? Oh my star, she is just so handsome! Does she have a name yet? What's her drive model? Oh, gosh. Listen to me babbling. When I was in Edgewater, I dreamed of flying on a real ship, working on a real engine, belonging to a proper crew. Edgewater won't last another season without power, but that don't change the fact that I'm indentured to Spacer's Choice. Company expects me back at my post. I worked on the occasional supply coach in need of repairs. Once I built a little model craft out of spare parts, but Mr. Thompson found out and I had to take it apart. I want to ask you something, and you can say no. But can I come with you? I could tend to your engine. I know my G-valves from my catalyzers, and I can keep your ship singing. And if you ever need a pair of eyes watching your back, I can do that too. What do you think? Yes! I mean, thanks. You won't regret this, mister. Captain. I can call you Captain now. Ha! I got a captain.
Captain, I have detected that the town of Edgewater is now without power. I appreciate you doing your part to hasten their demise. What can I do for you, Captain? Do you know how to install a power regulator? Outstanding, Captain. Your aptitude for engineering will prove invaluable in the event of another catastrophic engine failure. Our engine room is located behind you, across the cargo bay, up the ladders. What can I do for you, Captain? All systems are operating within acceptable parameters. I am prepared to bring the Unreliable into low-altitude orbit. This should prove an adequate test of our flight capabilities.